reason why we're interested in personalized medicine is that we are funding a big body of research, and we think we have a role to play in research, mainly by breaking down barriers. We've got a potential to break down barriers among countries, between countries, because we act at the European level and beyond. We have also the possibility to break down barriers between organizations, because typically in our project we have not only the academic sector, but also the hospitals, the industry, the SMEs. And we can also break down barriers between the different disciplines, which I think is an important thing for the personalized medicine. Our main policy drivers are to improve the health of the human population, but also to increase the competitiveness of European health-related industries and businesses. You have to understand that our involvement in the support of research is linked to the market, we can also address global issues, including emergencies. And for that, we have currently a budget of 6.1 million euros over 7 years. This is to say that, in fact, as a public institution, we have to work into a good frame, so we have a framework program which is defined for 7 years. We are currently in the 7th framework program, and the framework program is implemented through specific programs. So we have 4 specific programs, and the major one is the cooperation program. And what I mentioned previously was for the health team was within this cooperation program. I'm not going to go into the details of the program. We think that's a good time for us to get involved in this thing, first of all because of personalized medicine is an emerging area, there are a lot of questions, and I think that the scientific community, medical community is already involved in the industry. Also, as it has been mentioned previously, there are a lot of questions arising along the full innovation cycle of the pharmaceutical industry, so personalized medicine is an option. It's timely for us in the context of the Innovation Union, which is an agenda for 10 years, and more specifically, it's timely since we are getting at the end of our federal program. When I say the end, in fact it's 2013, but it takes about 2 years to have a new program adopted. So we are now really thinking about what we have next in our program. We have organized a series of workshops last year and a conference this year in May. And I just wanted to mention that key challenges have been identified by the experts of the conference. First, we have to generate knowledge and develop new tools. It's not only development of new tools, but also improving existing tools. We have emphasis on the standards for data and sample collection. The need to link also the clinical data with the molecular data to explore complex images. There was also another set of challenges identified with translation to medical applications. There was a lot of discussion about the biomarkers, there's a need for new biomarkers, but also, and this has been mentioned also, the necessity to validate these biomarkers, because a lot of application on biomarkers and validation is an issue. Also, we have to use the biomarkers in the clinic, and we also have learned that there is a need to adapt, this has been mentioned also by the previous speakers, the clinical trial methodology to the stratification of patients' population. So there are a lot of questions in this respect. This is something which is of first interest for us as it addresses research issues. But there are other issues that have been addressed in this conference. We have, and this was emphasized yesterday, to break barriers and speak this common language with an effort of, to have different people from different disciplines talking to each other and working together, and also the necessity to integrate personalized medicine with training and education. And there was also discussion about the economic aspect. I'm not going to enter into it because I think Dr. Brill